Hey, boys. Hey, girl. And hello to Jack, Ryan's wiener dog, who likes to watch my videos, too. Hey, Jack. Oh, hey, wiener is what he said to call him. Okay. My good friend, Joe over at Southern Coastal Cooking, tagged me for the BBQ Tag Questionnaire video contest. And we've got some questions here. Let's see. First off, what's your go-to smoker? My go-to smoker would be, and that's a poser. Pose, we having a lot of people around here. I'd use my offset. It's got more smoking surface area. Great space. Real estate area to put a lot of stuff on. For a smaller cook, I'd use my Weber Smoky Mountain. And it uses less fuel, but it's doesn't have as much area. On my offset, I can probably get 14-pound briskets on there. On my Weber, my 18.5-inch Weber, I can only get 2. The offset gonna use more fuel though. Almost 3 times as much. Right? What's your go-to rub? JB's Head Bar rub. It's my go-to rub. I make it myself. And it is fantastic. And it's for sale. At my blog site. Link in the description box. So question number 3, what's your favorite, baby backs or spares? Well, spare ribs are the whole side of the pig, and there's several different cuts in there. Got the baby backs, which is the top section, and then your St. Louis cut, which is the babies with the a little bit more of the loin in them. And then there's the rib tips on the end. And then there's one other cut up in that section. What's my favorite barbecue channel? Mine. Louisiana Cajun recipes. What's my favorite beer? I like to drink a light beer. Less calories, less filling, and I can sip on it all day long and not lose my edge. I mean, I can talk real good, but at least I'm not laying on the floor passed out. All right? My biggest influence in barbecue. That's question number 6, by the way. That had to be my dad. Grew up every day I grew up, yeah. On Sundays, we would normally have barbecue, or Saturdays, we'd have barbecue. He'd normally make steaks, and I learned from him, and then learned how to smoke on my own, because he didn't really smoke much food, but he barbecued steak. Okay. I need to go on a little bit about that. Back when I was still in high school, before the senior trip year, when I got my driver's license at 15, down the bayou. That's the legal age was back then. We went to Panama City. Me and a partner of mine, a buddy. And that's a party place down at the beach in Florida, Panama City Beach. They had a place called Angelo's Steakhouse, and it's still in business today. And when we drove by it, looking at all the pretty hot babes walking down the street, blowing the horn and hanging out the window like Cajuns do, you could smell the smoke coming out the place. I said, man, we got to go there. So let's go on in there. Let me go get us some barbecue. Angelo's Steakhouse. Angelo's Barbecue. Panama City. Got a huge bull outside. I mean, must be a 10-foot-tall plastic bull in the parking lot. If anybody's been to Panama City, they know what I'm talking about. Went in there, and for the appetizer, they had these big beef ribs. And I seen somebody with them next table. Man, what is that? I ain't never seen that before. That's our barbecue ribs, beef ribs. I said, I want to get that. So they brought me that. It was the best ribs I ever tasted in my life. They were smoked, real hickory wood, whole beef ribs. I mean, plenty of meat on them. And when I left there, I was, what's the recipe? I need the recipe for that. Well, we can't give you that, but I can tell you. They just put salt and pepper on them and throw them in the smoker. Okay. And I'd been trying to duplicate them for years, and I finally got it down. Salt and pepper, throw them in the smoker. Let's see here. Where are we at? Question number 7. What are my thoughts on pellet, gas, and electric smokers? Those all work great for novice, beginners, people. You can set it and leave it alone. They don't add as much NOs and COs into the smoke chamber, which produce a smoke ring, as a real wood fire or charcoal fire does. And, but it adds enough smoke flavor to the food where it's gonna taste just fine. It may not be as pretty, smoke ring, and that adds no flavor. It's just, oh, cool, look at that. Don't that look nice? So I prefer a real wood or charcoal style smoker, whoever, Smoky Mountain or Offset. Question number 8, to sauce or not to sauce? I say no sauce. No, no, no. And yes, 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 yes. I like to put sauce on my chicken. But when you put sauce on chicken skin, it takes the crisp bite away. It's not going to have a nice crust, in other words. Whereas if you take the skin off and fry it in a pan, it'll be nice and crispy. Think chicken bacon. And just baste your chicken meat with sauce. So I'll put sauce on chicken. Never on ribs. Serve it on the side. Same way with pork butt and brisket. Make up your own barbecue tag question. What's your favorite barbecue side? Okay, there's my made-up question. Mine would be tater salad. barbecue beans, to name two. Want three? How about collard greens with bacon in them, smoked bacon? Number four. I'm not on the floor. I'm sitting in a chair. Would be Texas caviar. Google it. That's real good. So I've got to go ahead and tag three other people. First off, I'm going to tag Miss Linda at Linda's Pantry. Tag girl, you're it. And next, let's tag Tango Joe of the Tango Joe Show. Tell me what y'all think he sounds like when he's talking, or who he sounds like. Famous movie actor, TV actor, star, whatever. He's got that sound to his voice. I'm not going to go any further. And without further ado, let's tag so my tag number three is going to be that wild and crazy guy cooking with Surfinsapo. Tag boy, you're it. If you like what you see on my channel, please subscribe. Give me thumbs up on my videos. Tell your friends. Tell your family. A bye, a girl, a boy, a wiener dog. A bye.